My name is Matthias Sutterer. I work for a Drupal shop called Epico, and we are mainly focusing on building the open source recruiter distribution. And maybe you also know me from my contributions, like the taxonomy manager or the email field. But today, I'm going to talk about on how to make money with Drupal distribution. And it's not easy. So I have to disappoint those who expected maybe a simple recipe on getting rich by publishing, implementing, and maintaining distribution. It's definitely not easy. Or as Dries, the founder of Drupal, says in a more eloquent way, while we in the Drupal community continue to progress in making distributions easier to build from a technical point of view, we have yet to figure out the business model. And today, my talk is especially focusing on business models for Drupal distributions. So how can actually companies that invest a lot into implementing, publishing, and maintaining a distribution make any profit out of it? Before we continue, let's shortly take a look on the agenda today. I'm starting with a few words on distributions, followed by business models, some licensing issues, pros and cons, and afterwards I'll try to demonstrate on how we at Epico try to approach this issue with our open source recruiter distribution and our commercial variant Jobbico. And at the end, there should be enough time for an open discussion, as I'm also interested in your opinion on this topic. So, when downloading Drupal 7 and installing it, you'll get something like this on the first page. So you can read here, welcome to Drupal. No front page content has been created yet. So, in my opinion, this one doesn't really look ready. Of course, you can do a lot with Drupal Core. It's really powerful, and you can even extend it. But if you're having a specific use case in mind, maybe it's not the point you want to start from. And there's also a high chance that someone else had a similar use case before, and maybe even a distribution is out there. So you don't have to start from scratch. One of the best distributions I know is called Commerce Kickstart. It provides a full-featured shop system, including some example content and configuration. So after downloading it and installing it, you get this page here, which looks pretty awesome compared to Drupal Core, of course. Configuring Commerce, that Commerce tool suite for the first time, can really be hard. And this distribution shows the best practices on how to configure them, and it really gives you a feeling on how your shop could look like at the end. Another example I have here is called Drupal Commons. It's a ready-to-use solution for communities. So you'll get groups, blogs, comments, discussions, and so on. So, and after downloading and installing the full package, you'll get this page here with some example content, which again looks pretty awesome. The last example I'm showing today is called the recruiter distribution we at Epico did. It provides a full featured job board, so companies on the one hand can publish job ads, and applicants on the other hand can fill out resumes. And for both the applicants and the resumes and the job ads, searches are provided. I'll come back to the recruiter a little bit later, as it will serve as an example. Let's summarize the main points about distributions so far. They are a turnkey solution for a specific use case. From a technical point of view, they provide a core installation profile, bundle a few modules, themes, and features. Distributions can have different purposes, so they can range from a Kickstart distribution that should demonstrate certain functionality, to products that provide an out-of-the-box functionality, or even to complete platforms with integration possibilities. Another major aspect is that distributions are published under the GPL, as Drupal Core is. We're going to discuss the GPL issue a little bit later, As then on the one hand, it's really important for Drupal, but on the other hand, it's also making some business models harder. So I hope I could convince you so far that distributions are really awesome, and in my opinion, they are really essential for Drupal, for the ecosystem of Drupal, as they allow us to compete with other turnkey solutions and to enter new markets. But how actually can companies that publish and implement distribution and need to maintain it can make any profit out of it? So let's move on to the main topic of my presentation, business models for distributions. And I did some brainstorming and mainly grouped three different models. So the first one is customization and consulting, the second one hosting and support, and the third one commercial add-ons. This list doesn't mean to be complete necessarily, it were just the most obvious ones for me, and maybe we can figure out additional ones at the end. Furthermore, they are not mutually exclusive, so you should and can combine them, of course. The most obvious one for open source projects is, of course, customization and consulting, as it best conforms with our license. So you as a company or user maintainer, you publish a code, people are attracted, they download it, they use it, maybe they like it, and maybe they need some help and come back to you. This might work for smaller projects or for middle-sized distributions where we can maybe even finance part of your implementations via client projects. But I would say for bigger distributions, it might not be enough, and it doesn't scale that well. So for more, the more client work you do, the more developers you need. And in my opinion, these kinds of projects are usually rather from a small size, at least from the financial point of view, except you're really maybe building a whole portal out of your distribution. So consider this option, but for bigger ones, it might not be enough. The next logical step forward is to provide hosting for your distribution. And maybe even some support levels. So clients don't need to worry about the server setup, the maintenance, the installation, the bug fixes, and so on. You do everything for them. And you can even offer different support levels. Clients are always having to always having some questions, and they will come back to you, and they're going to be happy if you're going to do the maintenance, the security fixes, and so on. Based on the hosting and support, you can have different pricing models, and usually you charge on a regular basis, so you're also having a regular income. Hosting, in my opinion, and maintenance already scale quite well, so the more clients you have, the lower the cost per client are, at least if you're having a good server infrastructure, of course. Concerning the support, it's a bit more difficult. First of all, you have to think about how comprehensive your support should be, maybe even 24 hours the whole week, or maybe you're having some service level agreements in addition for hosting and support. If so, you're going to need a bigger team. And companies like Acquia are offering such services, but it might be difficult for you as a small team. The last and most interesting business model I'm going to present is selling commercial add-ons. It's complex because it might conflict a bit with the GPL, as we will say later. So the basic idea is that you are going to publish your base distribution, your base feature set, but you're having some commercial add-ons for which you can charge your customers. So see your distribution as an integration point. People download it, use it, and if they like it, like it extended, they are hopefully coming back to you. Extensions can be some kind of apps that have a feature set, Drupal modules or services, and to give a few examples for services are like a payment provider, an analytics tool, a search feature, a recommendation engine, and so on. You can implement the services by your own, or you can also act as intermediary for third parties. And this business model really is the one that scales, in my opinion. Because once you've implemented, you can sell it again and again and again. But keep in mind that you really have to find the right balance between what you publish in your base distribution and what you try to sell to your clients. And as distributions are GPL, most of the add-ons are going to be GPL as well. So selling in GPL is really a complex topic, but we are going to talk about it in a few minutes. So I presented basically three models, which were customization and consulting, hosting and support, and commercial add-ons. All three of them can be combined, and there's never going to be one right business model for all companies and all use cases. So think about which one suits for you. Distributions are a great way for building products, and also think about software as a service or platform as a service. And by publishing a distribution, you really get a lot of visibility on a Drupal market. So see it as a marketing channel. And I think there are going to be other options as well, and maybe we can also discuss a few at the end. So, GPL and selling. As already mentioned, Drupal Core is published under the GPL license. And every code that is bundled with Drupal Core is GPL as well, so are distributions. So, GPL means that you don't have to publish a code, but once it's published, people can have the freedom to download it, to use it, to change it, and to republish it. This still means you can't sell your code, but others can sell it as well. And if your business model is only based on selling the code, and someone gives it away cheaper or for free, your business model might be broken. This is also especially a problem for the third business model I presented for selling commercial add-ons, as they are often GPL as well, and if you're giving them away, you don't keep control. But as already mentioned, there's no need to publish every extension, so you can have a private repository and maybe also manage the code for your clients. And here, the best option is really to have services that just interact with Drupal and exchange data. So if you're having a service, it can also be published under a different license and kept in a private repository. And whatever happens with your code, you are the one who implemented it. You are the one who understands it best, so you are always going to keep the know-how. And most important, the GPL is not anti-commercial, although it makes it more difficult. It's anti-vendor lock-in. At least most clients feel that way. Before we move on to some concrete examples, I would like to talk a little bit about the advantages and the disadvantages of business models and distributions. First of all, by publishing a distribution, you get a lot of visibility on the Drupal market. See it as some kind of lead generation tool. Furthermore, it proves that you are really an expert in a certain domain. And it's one approach to build a great product. It really allows you to get away from the client-driven and project-driven work. Unfortunately, I think I could talk long about the problems on distributions, because a lot needs to happen on the business side. First of all, you really have high investment costs. Implementing a distribution really takes time and therefore money. So the best option here is that you can finance parts of it via client projects. Once you've implemented it, you need to maintain it. Maintaining in the sense of answering support requests, bug fixing, adding new releases, and maybe even upgrading to new major Drupal core version. So once Drupal 8 is out, people are going to start asking, when is your distribution ready? And upgrading to Drupal core, to Drupal 8, will again require a lot of investment. And if you're not going to do a good job in managing the community, you're even risking bad reputation. Furthermore, as already mentioned, your code is freely available. So competitors or potential customers can take it, can use it, without the need to consult you. They can even be seen as starting point for forks. So all the good things about the GPL are also a risk for business models. But don't get me wrong, I really like the GPL, and it's really way better to have the open distributions than to have some closed source distributions that don't integrate into the Drupal ecosystem. Now, I've given you a lot of theoretical input on distributions and business models. What I hope is also interesting for you is on how we at Epico are trying to tackle the main challenges around it with our base distribution recruiter and our commercial product called Jopico. As already mentioned, the recruiter is a Drupal 7 distribution which is freely available. It includes the basic feature sets for publishing jobs, for filling out resumes, for searching for jobs and for searching for resumes. And also a lot of details are included that we learned over the last 5 or 6 years implementing job boards. And we've also included a responsive theme, so it perfectly works on your mobile phone, on your tablet, on your desktop PC. And on the right side, you can see a small screenshot of the mobile version. From time to time, we even do some recruiter consulting. But what is more important for us, at least from the commercial point of view, is our product called Jopico. So you can imagine Jopico as a toolbox or a set of building blocks like Lego that provides extensions for which we charge our customers. Extensions can be, for example, a billing system, analytics tools, recommendation engines, and so on. And most important here is that Jopico is fully compatible with the recruiter. So you can start with the recruiter and install certain add-ons later on. Furthermore, we've also grouped Jopico in three predefined packages, the starter, the professional, and the enterprise. And we are usually also including some consulting hours, some customization hours, and we are also offering hosting and support. Usually, for typically clients, we take the middle-sized package, the professional one, add a few features if necessary, and yeah, that's it. And to give you a feeling, the professional package is around 15,000 euros. But you already get a lot for it. So if you would try to implement the same feature set on your own from scratch, it would cost you way more. And as already mentioned, we also are offering hosting and support for Jopico. This means on the one side we're having a regular income, and on the other side we're also keeping control on our code base. So to get back to business models and our sources of revenue, as mentioned, we do a bit of recruiter consulting, but mostly we try to sell our Jopico add-ons or packages. In addition to that, we usually do some customizations and extensions, but here for me it's important to distinguish between customizations and extensions. So customizations are specific for one project, they can only be charged once and cannot be reused. And maybe on the long term, you're even having maintenance costs for it. Small interruption. So, and extensions, on the other hand, are usually more generic and can be reused across projects and are going to extend your ecosystem and can be resold. So the best approach is that you try to build generic extensions that still fulfill the client's requirements. And we are also offering hosting and maintenance. But we are not having that kind of comprehensive support for, like, we're not available for 24 hours the whole week, definitely not. So we are actually covering all three business models I've presented, but are focusing on selling Jopico packages as this approach really scales. We've already implemented it and we can sell them again and again without high costs. And we are having another source of revenue, which is maybe untypical for Drupal shops. We are also operating job boards on our own or with partners. And if the job board works well, it's also a kind of revenue source. But here you have to keep in mind that you are going to need a separate team for it. Your Drupal developers are not going to operate the website. Here I have another slide on our customers. And I've grouped them into three segments based on their motivation or reason of choosing us or Jobbiko. And for the first segment, the customer really came via Drupal. So maybe they already have a Drupal website running and need a job board. Or maybe they even installed Recruiter, but figured out it's better to consult us. So for them, the main motivation was Drupal. For the second segment, I can't say for sure what their main motivation was. Maybe Drupal, maybe other channels. So they were focusing on the product, on the Jobbiko product. But still, they really like and appreciate Drupal. They feel like they are buying a standard software and don't have the kind of vendor login. And the third segment is targeted via niche-specific channels. So they don't know anything about Drupal yet. They only care about the product. Currently, I would say segment one and two are the bigger ones for us. But the one with the highest potential is segment three, as it really allows us to enter new markets and enter new bigger markets. But it's also the most competitive one. So here, please keep in mind that you should not only market via Drupal, but also outside of the Drupal world. This is all I wanted to say about our approach with Jobbiko and Recruiter. I hope I could give you an impression on how we try to tackle the main challenges. Of course, we have not solved all the issues, but at least we found a way that works for us. And I hope it's also some kind of motivation for you, maybe if you're thinking about publishing a distribution. And now let's wrap up the main things. So commercializing the distributions is really still hard, but possible, as I showed you with different business models and our approach. You have to think about which business model suits best your use case, because there's never going to be one right answer. And be creative. Second, distributions are a great approach to build a product and a platform that scales. So it's one chance to get away from your project or client-driven work. And by publishing a distribution on Drupal.org, you get a lot of visibility. So see it as a marketing channel. But don't see it as your only marketing channel. Also market outside of the Drupal world. And try to build really commercial services or really an ecosystem around your distributions where maybe also others can integrate. So distributions can really be the game changer for Drupal or for the ecosystem of Drupal. But in my opinion, it still has to happen. Still, a lot has to happen on the business side. So now feel free to ask me any question about this topic or to tell me your opinion about it. So. It is, but I think it can be. Currently, it is not for us, because usually when you are a Drupal shop, you wanna get the money usually. So if someone is coming to me and saying like, I would like to have a shop system, yeah. I'm suggesting like I can implement it for you. And maybe I'm going to use the commerce kickstart. So usually sorry, it's better. No. So easy. At least we figured out at the end.
Yeah.
I Yeah, it would be great if companies would work more together, but it's usually a bit difficult, I would say. But and also if you're getting a request for a job board, maybe we would think about using the recruiter instead of coming to us. Yes. Sure, we would do it, but usually we're not contacted for this kind of work. Sure, that also market for two other tuple shops out there. Yeah, sure, it's a good that's great, yes. So, any other questions? Yes, please. Sure. Sure. Internally, we have some kind of a master demo with one repository, and we just clone it. So it's more or less a software as a service. So usually our clients don't care about the code, the hosting, whatever. But it depends. It's also there are different options possible. So if a client really wants to have the code, he can have it. Yes, we do. I would say 70 or 80% of our work is based on recruiter distribution, but we are also doing two typical other Drupal projects. So, any other questions or any other opinions? Nope. Yeah, would be bad. You have to think about the contract. Before giving away your code, think about the contract, and usually our clients are interested in the product, not the code. They are not going to resell it. They just want to have a working solution. But yeah, it's a difficult topic, sure. And as mentioned, you're always going to keep the know-how. But still, if you really try to charge a lot for it, and then it's also freely available as download, difficult. Yeah, sure. Yeah, yes. So for example, we are a small company, so we cannot do all the support. If we really would have a bigger client or a huge client base, so you can also get in contact with the bigger companies like Acquia or the other ones that are really offering a 24-hour support. And also, I'm regularly taking a look at the commerce distribution to just see what they do and how they implement stuff. Yeah, that's another big issue. We are still thinking about when is the best time to move on to Drupal 8. We were one of the first with the Drupal 7 distribution, and our distribution was also a use case for several modules like the Search API, the Field Collection module, and so on. And if we would start now, it would really be too expensive. So I think we're going to wait at some time now. And but if a client is coming and says, okay, I don't want to use Drupal 7 now, it's so old. I want to have Drupal 8, and he's going to pay for it, we're going to upgrade.